In the last video, we talked about what an interactive novel is and why we are making one. In this video, we are making the UI layout for our interactive novel game. This is going to be step by step, so I would advise you to watch the whole thing carefully to be able to accurately duplicate what I will be making. Ready? Now, let's jump into the Godot editor. We are going to be working in compatibility mode. You can use forward or mobile, it doesn't even matter, it's a text-based game after all. In the file structure here, we have four folders: assets, logic, resources, and scenes. In this video, we will be making a mockup of how we want our game to look. There will be no coding in this video, just making the layout. With that said, let's dive into it. But first, we have to go to the project settings, change the viewport to 480 by 853. Set the stretch mode to canvas item and set the handheld orientation to portrait. Create a panel container as the root of a new scene. Ensure the panel container covers the viewport. Add a margin container as a child of the panel container. This node will house every other node in the project. In the inspector tab of the margin container, go to theme overrides. Under constants, set the margin to 10. This will create a sort of padding in the panel container. Add a VBox container to the margin container. The VBox container node arranges its children vertically. Go to theme overrides, constants, and set the separation to 20. Add a HBox container to the VBox container. The HBox container node arranges its children horizontally. I will go to layout and set the custom minimum size to 68. Add a label. This label will display the player stats. Also, add a button node to be used as a menu button. In the label node, I will put some placeholder text. Then go to layout and under container sizing, tick the expand horizontal box. In theme overrides, get the font size to 23. For the button text, I will write menu, then go to layout and give the button a minimum size of 100. In theme overrides, set the font size to 20. Now, select the VBox container node and add an H separator node. The H separator node adds a horizontal line to separate content. Select the VBox container again, but this time add a scroll container as a child. In its layout, under container sizing, take the expand vertical button. Now, add a VBox container as a child of the scroll container. This will be where the story elements and choices are rendered. Rename it to content container. Add a label to content container. In theme overrides, change the font size to 22. In the text of the label, write title, as this will be our title text. In the content container, add a text threat node. This node will be used to display an image after the title, like you can see in this wizard choice scheme. Set the minimum size on the X to be 460. For this particular project, the recommended size for image assets will be 460 by 460. In the content container node, add a rich text label as a child. This node will handle the main story text in the game. Enable BP code so that we can have fun with our text. Enable fit content and disable scroll active. In container sizing under layouts, click the expand vertical button. Go to theme overrides and change the font size to 20. Now it's time to create our choice buttons. Create a margin container node. Go to theme overrides and in constants, set all the margin to 20. Ensure the margin container node is a child of the content container node. In the margin container node, add a VBox container. In theme overrides, constants, set the separation to 15. Add a panel container to the VBox container. Under layout, set the minimum Y value to 45, and in theme overrides styles, set the panel to style box empty. We can now add our button node as a child of the panel container. In the focus tab, change the mode to none. Add a margin container node to the panel container node. Change the mouse filter to ignore. In theme overrides, change the margins to 15, 9, 15, 9. Add a label to the margin container. Change the font size to 20. Write placeholder text. rename the panel container to choice container. The choice container and its children will represent a single choice button. We can also add more choices by duplicating this choice container, and we can do that in code. Now, let's go back to the first VBox container that started the whole show and give it an H separator child. The VBox container gets yet another child that is an HBox container named HBox container 2. HBox container 2 gets a button child. This button could be an inventory button or something, but for now, we will call it the subscribe to Red Indie Games button. Speaking of buttons, you should smash that subscribe button. It's just a simple tap on our road to 500 subscribers. Now, I'm going to try and populate the rich text label to show you how the whole arrangement works. Let me rename the root node to game scene. Save it in the scenes folder and run it. As you can see, the choice buttons are positioned relative to the text. Now, I will add an image to show you how the game project is going to look. I will drag one from my desktop. Remember, the image should be 460 by 460 for it to look good in the game. Let's run it, and behold, we are done with the layout of the project. Here is the node structure for the game screen scene. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe and leave a like. It encourages me to make more videos like this, and don't forget to comment your thoughts, suggestions, and questions. This video just covered the layout of our interactive novel or text adventure. In the next video, we will go into some coding to make stuff actually work. If the next part is out already, you will see it here. Else, why not get an idea of how UI mechanics are coded with this video?